I'm so privileged to stand before you tonight. My name is William, for those of you who don't know me. Some people call me a bishop, but I'm not. Others call me apostle, I'm not. In fact, to be called a pastor is the highest honor which I don't deserve.
No quit for a pastor who got the Dagachiro Nahuiri.
I prefer when people call me by my name.
Hallelujah.
So tonight we are going to share with you the word of God. And I pray that the message is going to change all of us. We are going to read only two verses. Here we go. It's in Proverbs chapter number 4, verse 6. Do not forsake wisdom. Do not forsake wisdom. And she will protect you. Love her and she will watch over you. I love
the
English version because it sounds better here.
It's better
to explain from me. Do not forsake wisdom. And wisdom will protect you. And surprisingly, wisdom is referred to as a woman. Because wisdom is referred to as a she. She will protect you. When you love wisdom, she will watch over you. So wisdom is like a woman.
Okay,
no wonder God calls her a her. She's a she.
Niwe,
next verse. The beginning of wisdom is this. Wisdom, though it cost all you have,
no
understanding.
No ubwenge bwa gutwara ibyo ufite byose. Shaka gusobanukirwa.
So we are going to talk about two words, wisdom and understanding.
Tugiye kuvuga ku magambo abiri, ubwenge no gusobanukirwa.
Because for us to develop, for us to be better human beings, we have to have wisdom and understanding. Let me tell you this. Many years have passed and believers believe that only Christians should die poor. It's like we don't see riches coming our way when we are Christians. And every time the messages are preached, they talk about God will love you, God will take care of you, but they don't tell people how God can transform our lives. Because when you lack wisdom, However much you work, you will never be successful. Now, wisdom is like a house full of treasures. But understanding is like a house full of treasures with open doors. So the Bible says the beginning of wisdom is this, get wisdom. Though it may cost everything you have, get understanding. You have to have understanding. In the churches, we don't have understanding. We have to dance, we have to sing, which is good. good. But we don't understand the will of God. The will of God is not poverty. If there's a dangerous thing ever, is poverty. But poverty comes our way because of lack of understanding. So wisdom is supreme. The Bible says, therefore, get wisdom. Though it may cost everything you have,
get
understanding. Because when you understand things,
you
know how to get the results. If you don't understand things, you will never access results. So I'm speaking to the youth today. You have to be people with wisdom. Be selective. Don't take everything on your way. Have understanding. I love to tell people. The reason we have so many poor people
is
because there are so many poor ideas. The reason why we have few rich people
is
because we have few ideas about riches. Now I'm going to surprise you. You may have the Holy Spirit inside of you. You may have the Holy Spirit, you speak in tongues. Even demons obey you. But then you lack understanding. God will never bless you in your laziness. You know, this is the message we don't hear in the church. The church will have to say, God is going to bless you. But how? You are walking like a snail. You expect God to bless you. Because the giraffe walks knowing where
he's
going. But we walk like we don't know where we are heading. Chinese walk fast. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Have you ever seen people who walk like they don't know where they are going? And when they are in the prayer room, pray, God bless me. God bless me. But how? You need understanding. Because Chinese know things. Americans know things. They don't have a minute to waste.
But
Africans, like we are going nowhere.
You
have to work out.
To be able to
understand it.
To get up so much.
Number two. This animal will eat on tops of trees. For me to explain this point, I'm going to use another example. We have these two animals. One of them is a giraffe. Another one is a tortoise. Surprisingly, when where they are standing, they occupy the same space. But the height is different. Please help me to understand this. Here are two animals. One is very big and tall. But one leg is here. Another one is here. Like within 1 meter. So the giraffe occupies the same space of land.
twiga ifata umwanya umwe gusa ku butaka umwanya ungana n'uw'akanyamasyo.
When you go to American homes,
iyo ugiye mu ngo z'abanyamerika,
most of them have small houses.
Bamwe muri bo bafite inzu ntoya.
When you come to Africa,
iyo uje muri Afurika,
some people have extravagant houses.
Bamwe bafite inzu nini cyane.
10 rooms, 2 people.
Inzu ifite ibyumba icumi ku bantu babiri.
But they are still walking like this.
Ariko bakaba bakigenda buhoro.
Because they are greedy.
Kubera ko?
They are greedy. Now, these two animals here, surprisingly, this tortoise will eat on the lower ground. The giraffe will eat on top of trees. Now, the point I want to share with you here. When you eat on top of trees,
iyo urira ku shore shore,
this animal is eating at his level.
Iyi nyamaswa irimo irarira hashika.
And surprisingly, because of his height, he can see far away.
Kubera uburebure bwayo cyangwa indeshyo yayo, ishobora no kureba kure cyane.
And the tortoise,
akanyamasyo,
which surprisingly shares the same space,
gahushe aho kaba gahagaze na twiga,
cannot see beyond 10 meters because he's down.
He got shown an operation to be very hard.
I want to tell you this. If you want to develop, first of all, you have to have wisdom. Number two, you have to have understanding. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God wants you to be like a giraffe. A giraffe has a vision of eating on top.
Twiga ifite inzozi zo kurira hejuru.
And a giraffe has a vision of looking very far.
Ndetse twiga ishoboye cyangwa ufite inzozi zo kureba kure cyane.
When he's feeding on tops of trees,
iyo irimo irira ku bushorishori,
he doesn't care about the tortoise which is biting him.
Ntabwo ijya yita ku kanyamasyo kayishunye hasi.
Because a giraffe has a vision.
Kubera ko twiga ifite inzozi.
Now I'm talking about you today.
God created
you with a purpose. God created you with a vision.
Now
tortoise, but your vision, when you try to look down, it's a step. If you ignore a tortoise, then you look forward. Sometimes here in Africa, we spend all our time bothering about the tortoise. We don't want to see far away. We don't want to go far away. Be like a giraffe. Ignore the tortoise. Young man,
Bangatoy.
You don't get married to a tortoise.
Busi yerushaka kanyamasyo.
Hallelujah. Because those tortoises are going to take all your time.
Kubera ko ubwo bunyamasyo buzatwara umwanya wawe wose.
Young girl here,
abakobwa batoya muri hano.
Ignore those men who come like a tortoise.
We are going to
waste your time.
Bagutakariza umwanya.
Snitch you down.
Bagushuna hepfo.
So that instead of looking forward,
kugira ngo hokugira kure kure, utangira kureba hasi. Ntabwo
utakanyamasyo.
Utwiga. Imana yakuremanye intego. Imana yakuremanye inzozi.
Reba
uhindure ibigukikije. Ukeneye ubwenge. Ukeneye gusobanukirwa. Reka tujye haleluya.
When God created this giraffe,
he gave
him a long neck. And for the long neck to function, a giraffe needs a big heart.
Giraffe cyangwa agasumbashyamba gakeneye umutima munini.
The heart of a giraffe
is 12.5
kilos.
Opima ibiro
12.5. Because for the giraffe to shake his neck,
kuko kugira ngo agasuma shyamba kazunguje ijosi
ryayo
gakeneye umutima ukomeye kugira ngo usunike amaraso
uburyo
imana rero yaremye inyamaswa iyo ikonze cyangwa ihimye ijosi ryayo kumara umwanya
munini
izagira izaterwa n'uburwayi bw'umutima
to a bent neck.
Kubera ko uyu mutima ntabwo uzashobora gusunika amaraso mu ijosi rihirye.
But God gave this animal a big heart.
Ariko Imana yahaye inyamaswa umutima munini.
And then a tortoise.
Ariko akanyamasyo.
Has a heart equivalent to the size of my thumb.
Akanyamasyo ko gafite umutima ungana n'igikumwe cyanjye.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
As I come to the end.
So,
God created you with a heart that should contain all the things that matter. Your heart should pump blood. But you have to guard your heart with all diligence. Because it's through your heart. God restores the issues of life. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Now this giraffe, with his heart, he's able to walk 450 miles an hour without getting tired. But the tatas, which gives him much trouble, can walk 1 kilometer in 5 days. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So God gave you a heart that you should guard diligence. And your heart is so big that it should contain more than you. If your heart is going to take care of only you, then your heart is like the heart of a tortoise. But because God gave you a special heart, your heart should contain yourself. Your heart should contain your family. Your heart should contain the broader picture of people. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
But then your heart should be guarded with diligence. Ladies and gentlemen, for us to grow, for us to develop, we need a heart that is not selfish. We need a heart that contains you. We need a heart that contains other people. But a heart that is not a trash heart.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We need to be like a giraffe. Because if he makes a mistake, and bends his neck for a long time, the heart will never pump blood enough to the whole body.
Why am I saying this?
When we allow our hearts to be distracted by tortoises,
develop
a heart attack. And we pray, God heal me, God heal me. Demons have attacked me. Those are not demons. You know, if you look for demons where they are not,
you can't
understand it. You lack understanding. So as I come to the close, ladies and gentlemen, for us as a church to move another step, we don't have to sing a lot. We should not necessarily sing a lot. We should not pray a lot. Before we pray, and before we sing, and before we dance, we need to know certain things. Do you know sometimes we pray out of ignorance? We are asking God to give us what He already gave us. We need understanding. One thing I have noticed in Africa. One person told me, and if you want to hide information to Africa, write a book. The reason why we dance but we don't get blessed. The reason why we pray but we don't get blessings. It's because we sing and dance in ignorance. We pray in ignorance. Because there is a book that is above every book. We don't read this book. When you don't read this book, even pray, you can ignore. Because you are praying out of ignorance, it is your prayer will be effective if you pray in this book. Don't be like a tortoise. Be like a giraffe. Because the giraffe knows where he's going. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And a giraffe has a heart.
If in the Mutima
is big enough to contain himself,
and
take care of his environment, your heart is not small, but your heart is limited to you.
Because
feeding your heart with tatas mentality.
Just
start
around.
Once you don't know things, you are ignorant. Once you lack information, the reason why people are rich, because they have access to certain information. They know what to do. They know where to go. Because they have information. The reason why there are so many poor people is because they lack understanding. Lack of understanding is not the will of God. It's the will of human being. You either choose to be following a tatas or look forward and move on. Some of us here have been taken away by tatases. God did not create us to follow the tatas. God created us to make a big impact. In Jesus' name, let's pray. Heavenly Father, I announce to the youth tonight that no matter what promises you have given us, yes to us, will come to pass. I pray that in all they are getting, may get understanding. May it change us, Lord, today.
That to hear your voice.
So that we can know that wisdom is a principal thing. Therefore, we should get wisdom. Though we should saying everything we have to get understanding. In Jesus' name. Father, bless every person in here. But more importantly, open the eyes of understanding. Open our ears. So that we can, in the middle of the night, we know what you desire us to. In Jesus' name. Holy Spirit, please take me dominance. And have your way. In Jesus' name. I'll give a big shout to Jesus.